behind the net, sends in front, shot on! That one is into the belly of netminder Ryan Dubé. And Nick, tell us what the Sault Ste. Marie native has done over these past few games.
17 games started. He's one of the top in the league. He's fourth in the OUA with about 2.39 goals against average, 0.89 save percentage. But no, he's really one of the elite performers in this league. Obviously, capitalizing on the non-performance of Matthew Dopudu, who hasn't started in at least the first semester and seen limited ice time the second semester.
That one does manage to eke outside of the blue line, so we'll get a whistle. And indeed, you mentioned the emergence of Ryan Dubé as the stabilizing force in between the pipes there for Carleton. And in the absence of Matthew Dopudu, as you said, ineligible in the first semester, hasn't really played a lot since coming back, and Dubé has picked up the slack and really done a pretty sensational job for the Carleton Ravens.
No, very true. I can point to a couple of performances this season where he's really held the Ravens in. Matthew Dopudu obviously had the number one coming into the season. A great performance last year, especially in the playoffs too against Toronto and UQTR, but Ryan Dubé has really exerted himself on this position and shows why he should have the opportunity to be the number one goaltender.
Carleton sends that one down as the captain. That's Gray, who's going to work out of his own zone with 35 seconds to go in this power play. Neutral ice picked up by Joey West, but he'll send that one to a Nipissing Laker. That's Cook. He'll send across for his captain, Gray. Fires that one in deep and into the corner. That's Stanish, who's going to battle with his man. Sent to the blue line for Cook. Cook with a bit of space. Shot on! That one goes wide.
Far too much time for Cook.
Back to the blue line for Cook. Cook will send for Gray. Gray with a shot on! That one stopped. And swatted out by Jack Walterson. He'll get it down the length of the ice as the penalty expires. And Nick, as I was cutting you off there, you were mentioning that Cook had way too much time and space, and indeed he did. He got a nice look there, and the Nipissing Lakers with a couple of opportunities early on that power play.
I know, very true. As they said earlier, their power play, not one of the more consistent performers in the league. Their scores aren't that consistent in the league either. Only two players have hit double digits, while only around four haven't scored. But it's been an inconsistent offense for them as the Ravens start to break free.
Lyndon Bain with a shot on. That one stopped. Rebound! And that one is picked up by Nipissing netminder Daniel Spence.